It's why Weeksy said he's a unicorn. The whole NHL world looked around for a Milan Lucic. Tom Wilson is of the same ilk, where this guy, you think about his time with the Bruins, yes, the 2011 Stanley Cup, but the signature moments, the ultimate fiery competitor. There was a handshake line with the Habs that didn't exactly unfold the way they always do. But that's Lucic. That's why Bruins fans love the guy. He is the quintessential Boston Bruin of this era.
Right. And I mean, can you think of a better hand and glove fit for Boston Bruins fans? I mean, they love a hardy, gritty brand of hockey. Lucic brings that. They've really,
I would say
the game has evolved a lot since that time. The handshake.
Here we go. Our crew is amazing. Dale Weiss. We'll never forget it. We will never forget. Look at this. That's how handshakes don't always happen. In the Eastern Conference semifinal.
Somebody was just straightening out some stuff that occurred in the past.
That's what that
We're
was.
Just straightening some stuff out.
And the way that Lucic carries himself and carried himself, for him to come into that team, it really goes back to what we discussed earlier. You know what you're getting if you're Don Sweeney and you want that back. What does that tell you?
Yeah, it says a lot. And you know, it's a complicated industry, pro sports and hockey specifically. I mean, even though this was a guy that had nothing but great service for the Boston Bruins, rare does one player spend his entire career with one organization. But here's another rare opportunity where, having spent a long stretch of hockey with that organization and given them great service, a chance to circle back, even at 35 years of age. And here's the thing, Tony. I mean, you'll always have that physical presence, still very much feared within the NHL ranks. Milan Lucic. I mean, this hulking frame, 6'2", 6'3", 240 pounds.
Solid.
Terrorizes people out there on the ice. But, you know, his game under Daryl Sutter, while a member of the Calgary Flames, had kind of gone in ebbs and flows, but he's still been really, really productive. And I believe as he steps into the Bruins lineup, you know, there's space for him, not just in fourth line duty, but, you know, to play a regular turn, 12 to 15 minutes on a third line, and maybe at a lean time, you know, stretch into the second line as part of this Bruins forward course. So, again, another instance. We talked about this early in the broadcast. You know what you're getting with Milan Lucic. He's a great and proven pro. And never mind what you get on the ice, there is accountability within the room, and there's an important cadre of NHL experience that comes with him as well.
And when you've been to the mountaintop the way the Bruins were with him, there is that fond feeling, and clearly it goes both ways. The way he looked in that video, I've seen it a couple
genuine.
Times. That's genuine.
It's authentic.
Yes.
Without question. And I will make...
This is just priceless.
Just
in van.
Remarkable. Remarkable. What a great run that was. What a great finals that was. And that really was a Bruins team that, you know, most any Bruins fan looks back and, you know, would really probably place them among the, you know, the greats of
so
the
special.
Going back to the 70s.
Yes.
It was a remarkable stretch for that group.